A lot of fans wanted to talk about the underwhelming match between Britt and Mercedes. I had my take. Mark had his take. Bully, I know that you watched it, and the fans definitely had their take. What did you think of the match between Britt and Mercedes Moné?
There wasn't a lot going on in the match. There wasn't anything to really get into. I understand how in the beginning they were trying to tell the story of Britt hooking the, you know, hooking her finish, going for it early. I saw a lot more facials from Mercedes than I saw from Britt. I didn't see as much milking of the moments. And to compare it, go back and watch the match right before. MJF and Ospreay did a phenomenal job with their facials. A phenomenal job of milking of the moments. So you're seeing it done really, really well 20 minutes to a half an hour before, and then you're not seeing it as well in the women's match, which I think can take away. Although I thought Mercedes did a good, better job of showing her face, her frustration, her angst, whatever. There was some stuff, some mat wrestling early on that was, it was off. There was nothing to really get into. Now, here's an aspect that I think really comes into play. I looked at the timer on the pay-per-view when Britt and Mercedes went into the ring. 2.5 hours into All In before their match. How long was the pre-show? An hour? 2 hours? How long was it?
I think it was about 2 hours. But the fans, if you watch it, the fans were kind of flooding in at that time. It's not everybody was sitting in their seats for the entire 2 hours.
I'm going to say that by the time Mercedes and Britt went to the ring, they're getting about 3 hours of action. The match right before Britt and Mercedes was very much a follow that match. Ospreay and MJF could have, they got main event reaction, end of show reaction from that crowd. They told a great story leading up to All In, maybe the best story in AEW leading up to All In other than Swerve and Danielson. And Britt and Mercedes, to be quite honest. And they paid it off. Ospreay, the hometown guy, defeats MJF. That's the Tiger Driver 91, right?
Yes.
That story comes full circle that they've been playing with for months. Gets the 1-2-3. The place goes apeshit. 50,000 countrymen, 50,000 Ospreay fans, all screaming at the top of their lungs. If you look at the crowd from the time Daniel Garcia comes to the ring, they're standing on their feet the whole time. There's a lot of physical exertion. So they've seen an entire show that they've really been into. Now they get Ospreay and MJF, which is like they're expending so much energy, so much energy. Everything that they got left. They're on their feet. They're popping. They're screaming. Ospreay wins. Yay. Everybody is so happy. Dude, you only have so much gas in your tank. That is one of those matches that not many people can follow. I think Britt and Mercedes were a victim. I think 50% of the problem with Britt and Mercedes, for those people who are saying it didn't go right, it wasn't good, yada, yada, was the fact that they had to follow something that blew the people up after they had already watched 3 hours of wrestling. They needed a come down period. I don't think the positioning of that match is very smart. I would never have put that match on. It's too important of a match. Mercedes and Britt are too important a match. And I don't care how fucking good Britt or Mercedes are. They're not following MJF and Ospreay based on the story that they've told leading up to this moment and based on Ospreay's just individual performance of what he can do. It's a hard spot to be in. Then you give the people in the body of your match something that they really can't sink their teeth into until the Spanish Fly spot. If you go back and listen, once Britt hits that counter move to Mercedes, that's when they finally started to come around. Yeah, there were a little bit of CEO DMD chants from about 1,000 people. That wasn't 50,000 people. You want to know what 50,000 people sound like screaming in unison? Go back and watch the Guns doing the get the table spot. That's what 50,000 people screaming in unison sounds like. So I think it's a combination of all of these things. When they got to the end of the match, because of the bigger moves that they did, they got the people. I think during the body of the match, they didn't do so much. Thus, the people, it's like they needed a time to take a break. They were spent. They were blown up. If they had just had sex, they would have to smoke a cigarette to come down from it. That's what I believe happened. I think it's a very 50-50 thing. Listen, match placement is important. I can tell you for a fact, today just happens to be the 24th anniversary of TLC, the first TLC match at SummerSlam. Shout out to Devon, shout out to Matt, shout out to Jeff, shout out to Edge, shout out to Christian. My brothers in TLC forever and ever. I was specifically told TLC 2, WrestleMania, in the Astrodome, that main event talent told the office, do not put our match anywhere near that match. They wanted no part of it. They didn't want to follow that match. They didn't want to be anywhere near that match because they knew what that match was going to do to the people. If I'm putting this show together, I'm looking at Ospreay and MJF. I know the story that has been told. I know the one-hour match that they had already. I know how the setup is for tonight. I know that these people are going to go apeshit for the finish because hometown guy is winning a big one in Wembley. I don't know many matches that could have followed other than the main event. That's my assessment of everything. What say you, Dave LaGreca?
Now, what say you? I think match placement, we always talk about match placement being a factor. It's very difficult. It would have been very difficult for any match to follow Will Ospreay and MJF, though I think some of those matches definitely could have. Tony Storm and Mariah May being an example. I think if they would have switched those two matches and maybe Britt and Mercedes was on earlier in the show and you put Mariah May and Tony Storm on after MJF and Will Ospreay, because of the type of match that it was and the cinematic and everything else, I think it would have been a good follow-up. So I think you're right there. As I said, I didn't think it was a bad match, but it wasn't a great match. And I don't even know if I would call it even a good match. When you have a show like that and all the matches are delivering in a big way, and the one match that doesn't deliver the way that fans are expecting, I think fans need something to hate, so I think they directed all their hate onto that match. The one thing you said is 100% true, and that is the way that Ospreay and MJF were selling during their matches. And there's one particular point where MJF is selling his shoulder. Just look at the pain in his face. Not only is he showing it on your face, he's verbalizing his pain. We know what Britt just went through with her back. We know the story. And Mercedes was targeting her back. Britt, you know, kept putting her hand on her back. She kept selling her back as far as like putting her hand there. But I didn't hear it from her and I didn't see it from her on her face. Like you were saying, Bully, we know that Britt should be in extreme pain. Why is she not selling that to the audience where we're sympathizing with Britt and we're with her every inch of the way? Like, can she get back on her feet? One of the times after a big slam, she almost immediately got back to her feet. Sell, stay down. Let's see it on your face. Let's hear it, verbalize it, visualize the pain that you're in so we can take that ride along with you. That did not happen in that match on Sunday, Bully.
Unfortunately, certain wrestlers have the mentality that they have to always keep themselves strong. You can never look weak. Until the light bulb goes off as a baby face, whether you're just a baby face for a couple of months or you're a baby face for life, until you realize selling is my friend. Pull back behind the curtain a little bit. Had a match this weekend, right? Mm-hmm. Let's just say that the guy that I wrestled beat me up for 5 to 7 minutes. I let him beat the shit out of me. I sold, and then I sold some more. And all those fans, the 1,500 fans that showed up to the show in Salisbury, North Carolina for AML, were chanting and clapping and screaming, "Let's go, Bully." And when the time was right, I blew my comeback. And I backloaded the whole match, put him through a table, and everybody went home happy. Selling is the number one thing any babyface can do. But you get certain wrestlers, and I'm not isolating Britt here. I see this across the board. You get certain wrestlers who don't understand that selling is their friend. Now I'm gonna show you a moment in time where I am gonna prove to you where Britt might not be as comfortable with her selling as she should be. 2 weeks ago, Camille comes to the ring. Britt swings the kendo stick. Camille catches it. Camille shoves Britt on her ass. And then Camille takes the kendo stick and snaps it over her leg. If you were telling the babyface how to react to that, what would you tell the babyface to do?
Holy shit. Like, oh my God. Holy shit. Look how strong Camille is.
You have to, as the babyface, you have to sell terror. You have to sell shock. You have to sell fear. Because if you, the babyface, sell that emotion, me, the fan, will believe you. Because you're telling me how to react. How did Britt react to Camille snapping the cane over her knee?
I don't even remember.
There was barely a look. And she got up and attacked Camille. Basically, you told me it didn't matter because all that did was incite you to get back up to your feet and attack. That's not what you do in that moment. You fucking sell to get Camille over. You selling Camille snapping the cane gets Camille over more than Camille snapping the cane. Some wrestlers just not comfortable. But when you finally get it, as a baby face, you realize that selling is your friend. When you finally get it as a heel, you finally realize it's okay to put your tail between your legs at times. It's okay. You're supposed to bump and feed for the baby face. You can lose every match. As a heel, you can always lose and get your heat back on the next one.
Bully, with the hatred that the AEW fan base has for Mercedes right now, if that story was played just a little bit differently, and I understand they were going with the selling of the back. By the way, the ending of the match had nothing to do with the back. So, like, the ending of the match didn't. You told the whole story throughout that match about the back, and then the ending had nothing to do with the back.